You are welcome to Osmosis Lecture Series. This is Osmosis Lecture Series on mathematics and other subjects. But in this series, we shall be treating mathematics, various topics on mathematics. So I will enjoin you to be part of this lecture series, which will help you, especially this period that most studies are going online. And those of you who do not have the opportunity of studying online, we have provided a platform for you to study right here in your various houses and sitting rooms using the Osmosis lecture series on VCD and DVD. So, with this lecture series, you will get the best of what education offers, like it is done in other Western countries. So, happy viewing as you participate in the lecture series. We shall be considering index notation or indices. Indices is the plural of index. An index is the small floating number that appears after a number or letter. It shows how many times a number has been multiplied by itself. For example, if you have something like 2 raised to the power 5, 5 here tells us or shows how many times 2 has been multiplied by itself. It tells us that 2 has been multiplied by itself 5 times. That is to say, 2 times 2 times 2 times 2 times 2. How many times? Here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So it tells us that 2 has multiplied itself 5 times. I want you to pay attention as we take this topic on indices. You will understand what the rule of the game is all about. Those of you in senior secondary 1, senior secondary 2, senior secondary 3, and even those people in tertiary institution will find this topic very, very useful. So, we shall also look at the laws guiding indices that will enable us to solve some problems. Examples, another name for indices or index is power or exponent. You call it power or what? Exponent. So when you hear exponential equation, power or index, we are still talking about indices. So pay adequate attention as we take this topic. You understand what the topic is all about, and it will help you in taking your exams. So let us treat laws of indices. The laws of indices will help us solve a number of problems in indices. The laws include Let's take the first law. If A, X and Y are real numbers. I say if A, X and Y are what? Real numbers. A, X and what? Y are real numbers. Then, if we have A raised to the power X multiplied by A raised to the power what? Y. This will be equal to the law states. These are the basis. These are the what? Exponents. Powers. Or index. So we say that you add the law states that you add the powers. The law states that you do what? You add the powers. I want you to pay attention. If you pay attention, you will understand what we are doing. I want you, after this lecture, after this class, you should be able to solve any question in industries. So let's take it. The law says that a raised to the power x multiplied by a raised to the power y. This is the multiplication law. The what? Multiplication law. Now you take one of the base and add the index. You take one of the what? Base. That is one of the bases and do what? Add the index. So here we have a here, we have a here. So we take one of the bases and add the index. So we have a raised to the power x plus y. That is the what the law states. We shall take an example to help us understand further this law. For example, if we have 3 raised to the power 5 multiplied by 3 raised to the power 2, this will be equal to, here we have the base is here, 3. We take one of the bases, 3, and add the index, which is what, 5 plus 2, which will be equal to 3 raised to the power 7. As simple as that. Are you following? So I want you to pay attention. We are taking advantage of the online training and the online lecture so that you study at home at your convenience. So this time around, you have to relax, pay adequate attention, and follow effectively in the class. So let us look at the second law. The second law states that, remember I said, if A, X and Y are what? Real numbers. So A can represent any number, X can represent any number, and Y can represent any number. I hope you are following. Anywhere you don't understand, you can call the number on the screen and ask your questions. I will explain your questions vividly to you. So, let us take the second law. The second law says that a raised to the power x divided by a raised to the power y. It's equal to, watch here. I want you to pay adequate attention. If you do, you will understand what indices is all about, or what we call the index notation. We have two bases here. We have two exponents here. So the law states that we take one of the bases and subtract the exponents. Here we take a raised to the power x minus y. Here is the multiplication law. Here is the division law. The division law states that when the bases are the same, you subtract the exponent in the division law. Are you following? Please pay adequate attention. Let us take an example. We can also repeat the example on top, but using the second law. Here we have 3 raised to the power 5 divided by 3 raised to the power 2. Following the law, this will be equal to 3 raised to the power 5 minus 2, which will be equal to 5 minus 2 is 3. This will be 3 raised to the power 3. So, this is the second law, and it is very, very simple. Now, time will come when you will have complex questions to solve. If you apply these laws diligently, you will be able to solve it. And that is mathematics for you. Let us look at the third law. The third law states that any number raised to power 0 is equal
to 1. Any number raised to power 0 is equal to 1. Let us use this example as a proof. The third law states that A raised to power 0 is equal to 1. A could be any number. Raised to power 0 is equal to 1. Let's prove this law. If we have something like A raised to power 3, are you following? Divided by A raised to power 3. If you watch here, this is a replica of the second law. If you watch here, this is a replica of the what? Second law. Remember, it is the same thing as writing it like this. A raised to power 3 divided by A raised to power 3. We have here A raised to power 3 divided by A raised to power 3. And this is also A raised to power 3 divided by A raised to power 3. Let us solve these questions simultaneously. A raised to power 3 divided by A raised to power 3. If we apply the second law, this will give us, they have the same base here and different powers, different exponents, different index. Do you know why I am using the redundancy repetition here? It is to enable you understand this terminology or nomenclature, indices. We take one of the bases and subtract the powers. So we say A raised to power 3 minus 3, which is equal to A raised to power 3 minus 3 is the same thing as what? A raised to power what? 3 minus 3 is what? 0. Now, here we have A raised to power 3 divided by what? A raised to power 3. This is equal to, remember, at the beginning of this class, I told you that an index tells us how many times a number has been multiplied by itself. Bearing that in mind, let us look at this. Sorry. A raised to power 3 means A times A times A all over A times A times A. So if A cancel out A, A cancel out A, A cancel out A, this will be equal to, remember, A cancel out A. If you have 1, 1 here, this cancel out this, 1, this cancel out this, 1. 1 times 1 times 1 is equal to 1. The same thing applies here, divided by 1. 1 divided by 1 is equal to what? 1. Therefore, I said what? Therefore. Therefore, A raised to power 0 is equal to 1. We solved the same question. This is A raised to power 3 divided by what? A raised to power 3. And here, A raised to power 3 divided by A raised to power 3. The same question we solved and have A raised to power 0. The same question we solved and have A raised to power and have what? 1. So, in the final analysis here, we say that any number raised to power 0, A could be any number. So, we say A raised to power 0 is equal to 1. So, we have just proved this law here, that any number raised to power 0 is equal to 1. In other words, if we have 3 raised to power 0 is equal to 1. If we have h raised to power 0 is equal to 1. If we have 90 raised to the power 0 is equal to 1. If we have 300 raised to the power 0 is equal to 1. Any number raised to the power 0 is equal to 1. If we also have z raised to the power 0 is equal to 1. So we are trying to explain the third law. So we have treated the first law, the second law, the third law.